night's first match is the Extreme Hardcore Title Match. Falls count anywhere, there are no disqualifications, only pinfalls and submissions. Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. We kicked off tonight's YTCW No Mercy with the announcer explaining that we will now be seeing a match for the Extreme Hardcore Championship. And making his way to the ring first is your Extreme Hardcore Champion, Steven from Level Down Reviews. And Steven again will be facing his thus far career-long rival, Ryan the Nerd Herder. So we'll see what Ryan can do tonight against the Extreme Hardcore Champ. And now, making his way to the ring from the Nerd Herder channel is Ryan. A man who is looking to get his hands on that Extreme Hardcore title one more time. And after winning I believe it was a tables match a couple of weeks ago, he finally is getting that opportunity at the Extreme Hardcore title shot here tonight at YouTube Championship Wrestling No Mercy. And in this Extreme Hardcore match, you can use weapons, you can use anything you want to, and pinfalls count anywhere. So if he gets the opportunity, he can try and pin Steven outside of that ring to regain the Extreme Hardcore Championship. Ladies and gentlemen, introducing first, the challenger, the Nerd Herder, Ryan! And your current Extreme Hardcore Champion, from Level Down Reviews, we have Steven. And here we go, the first match of YTCW No Mercy is underway. We got Ryan coming out on top early in the match with a running bulldog, now tossing Steven hard into the corner. Big boot to the chest. Taking a little too much time here, should be following up with an attack, not sure what he's waiting on. But yeah, a little bit of waiting, wasted some time there. Steven now delivering blows, just right hands over and over again. Ryan though, right back at him with an eye rake. Following up with a blow from himself. But now Steven got him up in that torture rack backbreaker, dropping him down. And again a right hand to the face. Now Ryan locking up from behind and hitting him with a turning back body suplex. Now wasting no time, immediately gets Steven up, tries to go for another right-handed blow. Oh, reverses it and then double reverse by Steven into a nice little DDT there. Steven now again working with those punches tonight. Seems to be his main form of attack. Ryan though stopping those punches, hitting him with a short arm shoulder tackle there. And a beautiful drop kick ending that combo. Steven though wasting no time getting back up to his feet, gets out of the way, hits him with a blow to the back and then a clothesline knocking him to the ground. Now going outside, I think we're going to be seeing some weaponry here. Steven underneath the ring looks like he's going. Yes, he has a sledgehammer though. Ryan though wanting no part of that knocks it out of his hands, but gets hit with a back body toss and then punches to the face. The official now coming outside. This is a falls count anywhere match, so he's coming outside. If there is a cover, he will be there for the count. Ryan now throwing Steven up the ramp, and Steven throwing Ryan back into the ring. And then catching him with that elbow across the side of the face, it looks like. And again going underneath the ring here. Looks like he's going to come out with... Looks like he came out with a chair. Again, Ryan knocking him down, though. And, oh, one leg flatjack maneuver for the cover. one, just one count there, very early in this match. Ryan with armbar reversed to an armbar to a short arm shoulder tackle. And oh, now slamming his head onto the concrete out there. There is that padding, but that concrete is right underneath it. Ryan now going for something underneath the ring. Steven, very interesting, not trying to interrupt him there, actually going to the other side of the ring. Ryan now with a garbage can, looking to take out the trash on Steven. Oh, and does so, hits him, oh, twice now. Oh, tried to hit him that third time. Oh, there's a third time setting him down, and another, just using that trash can over and over. Now a stomp to the inside of the knee there. Ryan again wasting no time getting Steven up, kick to the midsection, tosses him into the ring. He doesn't necessarily have to have him into the ring. Remember that this is a falls count anywhere. Ryan now, instead of following up, staying outside. Nope, now runs into the ring. Thought he might have been going for a weapon. Hip toss takedown there, goes for the cover. One, two, two count. Very close call for the champion there. Now Steven hard toss Ryan. Ooh, spear in the corner there, and a big knee to the side of the face. Steven now has got Ryan up. He's got him up for just a stalling back body drop there. Again gets him up. Ooh, a huge clothesline there, smacking him down. The cover, one, two, nope, just a two count there. Ryan kicks out. Steven now, he's got him up on his shoulder. This could be it. Here it comes. Boom, there it is. The sidewalk pancake goes for the cover again. One, two, three. Ladies and gentlemen, retaining his championship one more time. It is Steven from Level Down Reviews. You can see in the replay here, he gets him up on his shoulder and gets ready to deliver that devastating sidewalk pancake. And he doesn't have to worry about the ropes because this is a no DQ match, no rules, so there is no rope break. Gets the cover up there in the corner. But congratulations to Steven again defending his title tonight in another extreme hardcore match. I think Steven truly is setting the standard for what it takes to be the extreme hardcore champion. And tonight's next match is a mixed gender tag team match. And making his way to the ring first is Adam from Now's the Time For Show. And tonight, he will be teaming up with his wife Valerie from Nerdcore Arts to be taking on the tag team of Andrew the YouTube Critic and the VG Kid. And now, making her way to the ring, is Valerie from Nerdcore Arts. Valerie hasn't had a lot of singles competition recently, but tonight she will get in on some mixed gender tag team action with her husband, and she'll be looking to face off against the VG Kid one more time. Thank you. And now, making his way to the ring, is Andrew, the YouTube Critic. Yes, Andrew is going to be taking on his tag team partner tonight, Adam, in just an exhibition match tonight at YTCW No Mercy. It is a match type he had been looking forward to participating in, and I figured tonight would be a good enough chance to give him the opportunity to tag up with the VG Kid. I believe that these two are the two youngest competitors in YTCW, so it'll be interesting to see what the two young kids can do against this married couple. And making the way to the ring, Andrew's tag team partner, the VG Kid from the VG Dad channel. Yes, again, much like Valerie, hasn't seen a lot of singles competition recently, but tonight she will get some action in this tag team matchup. And here we go, start of the match, looks like Andrew and Adam will be starting it. Hits him with a quick arm drag takedown there. Adam trying to come in with a big clothesline, Andrew reversing that. Now Adam getting out of the armbar there, hits him with a knee to the gut, and then a huge belly-to-belly toss suplex. These two gentlemen working together should be very well versed in each other's maneuvers, so it should be interesting to see how they handle fighting each other tonight. Adam trying to go for that axe handle smash, Andrew blocking it. Now Adam gets him in a front headlock and a huge fisherman suplex there, taking him down. Thought he might have gone for a cover, instead just mounting him and going for those punches to the face. Now getting Andrew up, got him in a side armbar. Oh, and picks him up for a huge gut buster. Now we're going for the first tag of the night. Valerie now tagged in. Now, in an intergender or mixed gender, whatever you want to call it, tag team match, the men fight the men and the women fight the women. If there is any, you know, strikes between a man to a woman, it is a disqualification. So the kid tags out, and now it's back to Adam and Andrew. Adam runs in, hits him with another belly-to-belly toss suplex there. Andrew, though, immediately blocking that, gets up. The two men square up in the center of the ring. Adam gets from behind, rear waist hold, and the club to the back there, just creating a little separation, but Andrew immediately that spinning heel kick. Andrew now hard toss of Adam into the corner. Looks like we're going for the tag maneuver here. This is the only time that this sort of thing is allowed. But now that the kid has been tagged in, Adam needs to tag out. And instead, the kid tags Andrew back in. Just a little tag team maneuver there. And now Adam tags in Valerie. So, yes, there we go. Andrew is going to tag out to the kid here. And now we'll see the ladies fight for the first time tonight. Valerie wasting no time. Big boot to the gut. The kid locks her up, though, with a club across the throat. Gets her up again. Kick to the midsection. Followed up more kicks and a huge roundhouse kick, sending her down to the mat. Ooh, knee to the back, sending her almost crashing her head into the corner there. And now working on those legs with a huge knee stomp there. And she's got her up with that reverse suplex maneuver. Goes for the cover. One, two, three. Ooh, Valerie kicks out just before the three count there. And now she looks like, yes, there it is, set up for the Shining Wizard, hits her with that running kick to the head, dragging her away from the ropes again, probably going to look for the cover. One, two, and again Valerie kicks out on the two count. The kid, though, seems to be having her way with her back body suplex there, hitting her with all these maneuvers, including the Shining Wizard, which you'd think would have finished her off, but did not. Might be looking for the kid stretch tonight. One, two, Again, Valerie kicks out at about 2 and 5/6. Now looking to tag out to her husband there, Adam now in. And the kid tags out to Andrew. And again, the two men square up, and immediately Adam just takes him down with those blows and a haymaker at the end. Gets him locked up for it. Oh, looks like a half Nelson toss suplex there. Andrew, though, reversing out of the pickup, starts working. He's got him locked up in a... Oh, what is a leg DDT, sending his foot crashing to the mat. And again, tagging in the VG Kid. And now the kid actually tagging back out. Andrew comes in. Now Valerie comes in. Valerie charging in. And Andrew protecting himself with that arm drag there. But that is a disqualification. So your winners tonight are Adam and Valerie. And now, making his way to the ring is Steven from the Super Gaming Sibs, one half of the current YTCW Tag Team Champions. And this match now is for the YTCW Tag Team titles. Yes, tonight he and Chase will be defending against the tag team of the duo Master Thief Games, Cappy and OP. So as of right now, Steven, as usual, very excited, dancing his way to the ring. But we'll see if he'll be celebrating like this after the match. And his tag team partner, now making his way to the ring from sneaking through the crowd, is Chase from the Content End channel. Yes, there he is, the man who is very satisfied holding that YTCW tag team gold around his waist. I am sure he will be doing everything in his power to make sure he and his partner retain those championship belts. And now making their way to the ring, their opponents, the team of Master Thief Games, Cappy and OP. These two men again winning one more chance at that number one contender spot, and I'm sure tonight they will bring all they have to try and walk out as the tag team champions. They've had a few opportunities and just not been able to capitalize, but perhaps tonight will be the night that they get it together and walk away as the new YTCW Tag Champs. And here we see the official is showing off all of the championship belts here in the tag team match. Shows them off to the crowd. And both teams, I'm sure, are thinking of, you know, plotting their strategy now. And here we go. Steven and Cappy will be starting off this match. And Steven immediately with a Death Valley driver there, slamming him down to the mat. Sorry, not Death Valley driver, more of a Michinoku driver, my apologies. Now tossing Cappy around. Cappy, though, not having any of that, hits him with a kick and then a round-the-world DDT. Gets him into a side headlock there. Steven, though, gets out of it, takes him down with a leg trip. Both men just seem to be sizing each other up, doing a little bit of positioning here, turning back body suplex, tying up a little bit, some blows, nobody really taking any clear advantage here. Ooh, and as soon as I say that, Cappy hits him with that huge jawbuster across the top of his head. And again, locks up Steven, rear waist hold into a front headlock, into a stalling neckbreaker drop. Now taking a little bit of too much time, giving Steven the opportunity to get back to his feet. Ooh, blocks the kick and hits him with that back roundhouse kick. And again, both men lock up. This time Steven comes out, gets him with the front headlock, tosses him into his corner. And ooh, tries to go for what looked like a spear, though Cappy reverses it, tosses him into the corner. Going up top for something. No, almost for a tarantula-like maneuver. That is an illegal hold because he's wrapped up in the rope, so he had to let go of that very quickly. Steven, though, go for the front headlock. Cappy immediately gets out of it with that leg trip there. Steven now got him up again. Side armbar. Cappy, though, gets out of it with a quick arm drag takeover there. Again, both men lock up. Steven again with that front headlock. This time, though, hitting him with a huge belly-to-belly takedown. And wisely tagging out to his partner, Cappy has been delivering a lot of damage here early in the match. And still following up, now tagging out to his partner, OP. Now it's going to be OP versus Chase here. Chase, though, got him in a front headlock, follows up with a elbow to the side of the head. Side headlock to an elbow to the side of the head. Now an armbar. And another elbow to the side of the head and a side Russian leg trip there. Chase now race waist hold and again with that elbow to the side of the head. OP though, enough of those kicks, hits him with a huge clothesline. Oh, and a devastating toss into his corner. Nice little scoop slam there. Runs away and oh, hits him with a drop kick to the face. Thought he might have been going for a big boot. Chase again with that headlock into the elbow, and again the elbow to the side of the head. Perhaps he's just trying to dizzy his opponent right now, and oh, Steven lowering the rope, sending OP flying outside over the top rope. Chase, though, looking to keep... Nope, thought Chase might have been trying to stay inside, wait for that 10 count to retain his championship, but now goes outside to meet OP. And Chase now throwing OP into the ring. Looks like he was trying to grab him for something. OP, though, just getting out of the way. Chase now with the stairs. But I'll say, if you use those stairs, they will be disqualified. They would keep the championship, but they would be disqualified. Chase now needing to get back into the ring. And OP wisely tagging out to his partner there. So now we see Chase versus Cappy. And Cappy catches him with a swinging neck breaker there. Chase hits him with a huge arm drag takedown. Almost more of a judo toss there, really. And then a huge clothesline. Tried to follow with a boot there. Ooh. But see, Cappy rolled out of the way of that, then ran into the drop kick. Caught with a shoulder tackle. OP trying to interfere, it looked like there. Chase now outside, hits him with that flying crossbody. Surprised he's not going for the cover, hits him with that jumping elbow drop instead. Cappy, though, immediately back on his feet. It looks like he might be going for the Cappy combo. We've seen this before. There's the first drop kick. The second, we should be seeing the swinging neck breaker. And there it is, lands the Cappy combo successfully on Chase. Now getting Chase up to his feet, both men lock up in the middle of the ring, gets him into the side headlock, and then a head drag takedown there. Thought we might have been seeing that elbow to the side of the head again, and another crossbody splash there. Chase now getting Cappy up, hits him with an arm drag takedown, goes for the cover. One, two, and it looks like OP broke that up with a leg drop, and oh! OP just thrown in the air by Steven. Thought we might have been seeing the European uppercut, but instead just tossed into the air. Chase now going to the top rope. And oh, Cappy gets up, catches him off guard. Might be seeing, there it is, to put him to sleep. That could be enough. Goes for the cover in the corner. One, two, and Chase kicks out. Beautiful maneuver there, luring him in with a little fake there. Catches him mid-flight. Chase now hitting him with a running neck breaker. Goes for the cover. One, two, and Cappy kicks out. Cappy now hitting him with a leg drag takedown. And a huge kick to the back. and now tagging in OP. Little surprise there. Ooh, huge boot to the face. Little surprise because Cappy seemed to be doing very well against Chase right now. Perhaps wanted to stay fresh, tags in his partner though. And OP, as of right now, seems to be having no problem either. Hits him again with that scoop slam, might be going for the, there it is, the drop kick to the face again. And another huge leg drop from OP. Thought he might go for the cover there, instead gets him up for a nice stalling backbreaker. These two men now clearly working on Chase. And a stomp to the arm, not sure why he's going for the arm, just working on him. Kicks out on a one there. Chase, apparently a very tough competitor in this match. He's already been hit with one finishing maneuver, and OP has just been bringing the pain to him. And again, to the elbow to the side of the head. Chase is really going to start mixing up his maneuvers here. He's not really going to get very far with just elbows to the side of the head. Now we got a tag maneuver here. Drop toe hold into an elbow drop to the back of OP there. And Steven looks like he's calling for a choke slam or something. We'll see what's going to go on here. He's got him up. He's gonna try and do a tombstone pile driver. Chase now in, looking to, nope, misses there. The cover, one, two, through, no. Just before three, OP kicks out, keeping his dreams alive of becoming the next YTCW tag champ. Dodging out of the way of that big boot, OP now gets him to a side armbar, but hit with a reverse arrow, the knee to the gut, and a devastating German suplex delivered by Steven. Probably going to be looking for that cover again now. Rolls him over into the cover. One. Broken up by Cappy. And now OP just delivering those blows and a huge throat thrust there at the end. And another big leg drop. Steven has had a lot of opportunity to stand. Ooh, stand outside. Huge leap onto the gut and chest of OP there. So he's a pretty fresh competitor right now. Got him rolled over here. Schoolboy pin. Oh, reversed into a little sunset flip pin. Again reversed. Two. And it broken up by Cappy at the last second there. Nice little sequence of events there, back and forth. And Steven, huge, huge punching combo there. OP gets out of it, tags in his partner. Cappy comes in. Ooh, catches him with a blow to the face. Going to the other corner. And ooh. Chase catches him, hits him with a whip across the rope there. Perhaps should have just followed up on Steven instead of trying to go to the corner. Gets covered. One. And kicks out immediately after the one count. Steven to go for the rear waist hold. Toss into his corner. Setting him up upside down. Not sure what's going on. Oh, just kind of a choke there in the corner there, hanging upside down. And then boots and elbows to the back. Steven now pulling him away, probably going to look for the cover. Got him in the center of the ring. Nope, rolls him back over onto his back. I think we're going to see a gut-wrench slam here. He's got him up. Long wait, and there it is, the gut-wrench turnover slam. Chase now coming in to block OP. The cover, one, two. Kicks out after the two. Cappy staying in this fight. Oh, and hit with a European uppercut. That could be it. We have seen Steven win many matches with this move. Tosses him in the air, hits him with the European uppercut. One, two, and Cappy again kicks out. Not sure where he's getting the energy for this match. He has been the YTCW champion, so he is one of the better competitors. Kicks out on a one there. So perhaps he is digging deep, trying to become a champion one more time. Now OP with a mystery tag there. I don't think Cappy was ready for it, but honestly, I think OP saved him there. Steven had him in a nice little combo of punches. Oh, a huge stomp to that arm. Already was working on Chase's arm, now starting to work on Steven's. And that could be a good move there. Could take away that European uppercut or any of his toss moves. Chase now working with some kicks. Oh, OP though, blocking immediately. Hits him with a huge boot to the side of the face. And a rising knee to the head as well. Thought he might have been trying to go for that whole throat thrust combo there, but instead locks up, hits him with another rising knee to the face. Then catches him with that flurry of punches. And I think we're going to see it again. There's that scoop slam and the drop kick to the face. Going for the cover. One. No, kicks out. Sorry, not kick out. Steven breaks it up after the one count there. OP, not a very wise place to try and cover your opponent, almost basically in his corner. Chase now getting away, tagging in Steven. Steven coming in. Ooh, OP dodges out of the way of that one. But gets stuck into a side headlock, gets out of it though, and slams Steven's head down to the mat. Now going for what looks like a camel clutch. I believe it's a camel clutch, but Chase breaks it up immediately. I think we've only seen OP win one match by submission, so it was interesting seeing him go to a submission move there. Now both men in the corner had him in a rear waist hold. OP gets out of it, takes him out with a belly-belly takedown. Dragging him away, probably going to look for the cover here. There it is, one. And Steven kicks out after a one, doesn't even need his partner to come in and break it up. Had him in a side headlock to a front headlock to a rising knee to the gut, now into a rear waist hold and a club to the back of the head. OP just trying to control him, it looks like. And oh, there it is. There's a big boot to the side of the head. We've seen him do that in the past. And another leg drop there. Goes for the cover. One. And broken up by Chase. Cappy not coming in to help his partner there by blocking the opposition. Now he's got him in that cranium crusher maneuver. We have seen him win with this submission move. But Chase breaks it up. OP now grabbing his head. He has taken a few blows to the head, especially with those elbows. So he could be feeling the effects of those finally. And then a huge, huge snapmare almost across the ropes there. And Steven follows him outside. He's going to break up that count. Going to start back at one again. Dodges a clothesline, though OP is facing both men outside. Leg whip takedown. And a huge, another just stomp across the stomach there. I'll say, if OP wants to win this, he's got to get back in the ring. Chase, though, doing him a favor, throwing him in. But Steven doing him no favors by hitting him with a huge boot to the head out there. Now dragging away, probably going to look for the cover one more time here. Yep, there it is. Got him covered. One, two, and Cappy breaks it up. It looks like for whoever to win this match, they're going to have to take the opponent's partner out of it. They seem to be the X factor here. Anytime they go for a cover and the opponent, is still in the corner, they are able to break up these pins. One, two. This time, though, Steven kicking out before Chase can really interfere. Oh, and OP trying to go for a chokeslam. Steven saying no, reverses it. Oh, nice. Thought it was going to be a toss suplex. Instead, it's a bridging suplex there. Gets a two count on it. Cappy breaking it up. And here it is, the sibling slam. This could be it. Looks like Chase knocked Cappy off the apron there. Could be seeing the cover. One, two, three. There it is. Ladies and gentlemen, after the sibling slam, Steven and Chase are successful in defending their championship. A very hard-fought match by both of these teams, but Chase and Steven finding a way to dig just a little bit deeper than Master Thief Games tonight and come away with the win. So congratulations, gentlemen, on retaining the YTCW Tag Team Gold. And tonight's main event is for the YTCW World Heavyweight Championship. It is scheduled for one fall with no time limit. And making his way to the ring first is your YouTube Championship Wrestling World Heavyweight Champion, Thomas from PowerToMario. Yes, a man who very, very proudly wears the YTCW title around his waist. Very, very excited to have it back from Cappy as well. And tonight, he will be defending it against the man that he won it against in the original YTCW World Championship Tournament, the VG Dad. So we'll see if Thomas can come out on top one more time, just like he did in the first tournament. And now, making his way into the ring, is the VG Dad from the VG Dad channel. Yes, the VG Dad very excited tonight, probably more so than he has been in the past, because he again gets a shot at the YTCW World Heavyweight Championship. Introducing first, the challenger from the VG Dad channel is the man himself, the VG Dad! And his opponent from the PowerToMario channel, your YTCW World Heavyweight Champion, Thomas! Here we go, the official takes the belt from the champion, shows it to the number one contender, VG Dad, and holds it up for the crowd to see. And here we go, tonight's main event is underway for the YTCW World Heavyweight Championship. And I'm sure Thomas will do everything in his power to defend his title, already taking it to the dad as quickly as he can, not wasting any time as soon as he's down, picking him up. Dad, though, reverses Irish Whip and immediately reverses with a swinging neckbreaker. Both of these men do really like to rely on that swinging neckbreaker, so it'd be interesting to see if one of them can kind of neutralize the others. Thomas now with a huge Irish Whip there, catching them with a back body toss. And then a club to the back, now rear waist hold, and oh, just a drop across his knee there from the back of the VG Dad's head. And again, wasting no time, gets him up, another Irish Whip into the ropes, but the dad this time reversing it with the swinging neckbreaker. Now the VG Dad's got him locked up in the side armbar with a little snapmare there and an elbow to the back of the head, it looks like. Thomaso gets up, hits him, oh, and a back body toss, reversing out of it the VG Dad. Into a rear waist hold, and oh, a huge backbreaker across his knee there, kind of returning the favor. And there's that flying forearm smash, and then catches him with a springboard crossbody. And there's those cocky kicks. A little early in the match for that, I think. The VG Dad, a very tough competitor, so I'm surprised PowerToMario there already looking to be like, this is my match. Catches him with that choke drop there. Dad, though, ooh, huge throat thrust there, catching Thomas off guard. Thomas, though, catches him with that short arm elbow to the side of the face. Now again, another Irish Whip into the ropes, and that choke drop again. VG Dad really struggling to find any offense. Thomas really is kind of running the ring. Got him locked up to a side arm bar, wrenches it into another arm bar, then a blow across the shoulder. Now into the rear waist hold. The dad finally getting out of it, hits him with a belly-to-belly takedown. really needs to find a way to capitalize after that takedown there. Again into a side armbar. But Thomas finding a way to get out of it. Hits him with that short arm shoulder tackle. Into a side headlock. And a dropping neck breaker. It seems as soon as the dad gets anything going for him, Thomas immediately finds a way to counter it. Now again, both men locking up. Dad gets him in behind for a rear ace hold and a Russian leg sweep. Finally getting the opportunity to follow up some kicks. A little kick combo there. Again, taking him down. And oh, a boot to the face. Thomas immediately getting up. Kicks of his own to the gut. Hits him in a huge cross chop there, sending him down to the ground. Kicking him over onto his gut there. Not sure who he's going for. Instead, just picks him up. Dad, though, blocks the punch. Hits him with the right hand. Gets him to a side headlock. And, a huge jawbuster across his shoulder. Things seem to be going the way of the dad right now. Turning back body suplex there. Again, getting Thomas up. Side headlock. And a rake to the eyes. Now a rear waist hold into a side headlock. And another rake to the eyes. Following up immediately with some punches and an axe handle smash on the ground into a side armbar. Another snapmare takedown and an elbow to the back of the neck. The dad now finally finding some pacing here. Thomas, though, causing a little separation and a back body toss again from the dad. And then catches him with that swinging neck breaker. I think the dad really has started to find his pace in this match, mounting him, going for those punches. Surprised he hasn't tried to go for a cover yet. Thomas, though, blocking whatever the dad was going for. Huge kick to the gut. Getting out, it looks for a power bomb. No! Dad reverses the power bomb to a face buster in the corner of the ring there. Now locking him up just for a quick stretch there. Very similar to that camel clutch, just stretching out the back of PowerToMario there. PTM now with a club to the back of the head. And then another swinging neck breaker from the VG dad. Like I said, both these men really like to rely on that neck breaker as part of their main arsenal. And Thomas again catching him with that huge choke drop. Locks him up in the side armbar and a club across the arm. And there's the swinging neck breaker. I don't think we've even seen a cover yet, so I'm intrigued to see who will be the first to go for a cover in this match. And instead of going for the cover again, going for the mounting punches on Thomas there. Dad now got him up, tried to go for a punch. Thomas blocked it though, gets into a side headlock. And then just another cross chop. Now working on the dad's back. Pretty good move there from Thomas, always looking for the walls of Mario. So anytime he can get a little bit of additional pressure on the VG dad's back, that will be in his favor. Rear waist hold into a side headlock, into a side headlock takedown. Could be seeing the first cover. No, Thomas taking a little too long trying to decide what he was going to do there. And instead the two men, oh, about to say they linked up. Oh, there it is. Going for the walls of Mario. He's got him in the center of the ring. Could not get better positioning for this. There he is. Got it locked in. Center of the ring. The dad trying to make his way to the ropes. He's got a lot of energy. Seems to be getting there. He's almost there, but no. Thomas lets him go anyways before he gets to the ropes. And then hits him with the reverse Yoshi ride. That should be it. Thomas going to pull him away from those ropes and go for the cover. That should be it. One, two, no, the dad kicking out, digging deep and kicking out. I don't know how many times we've seen PTM go for the walls of Jericho, or not walls of Jericho, my apologies, walls of Mario straight into the reverse Yoshi ride and win it. Now with a rollover suplex, just a one count there. But the dad finding a way tonight to kick out of it, really staying in this match. But ever since the walls of Mario and the reverse Yoshi ride, PowerToMario really staying on top of him. Turning back body suplex there. Dad now trying to cause some separation. Ooh, hits him with that running drop kick to the knee. My apologies. Goes for the cover. One. Just a one count there. Finally gets that cover on PTM. Ooh, and there it is. The front Russian leg sweep. The cover. One. two, three. Oh, no. Thomas finding just enough energy to kick out, hits him with that forearm smash. I thought that may have been enough. Caught him off guard with the front Russian leg sweep. And now trying to lock him up, stretch out that back and that arm area. Again, just kind of applying the pressure to work on for the walls of Mario again. Releasing, slamming his head into the mat. Tried to go for a cross chop there. The dad, though, hits him with all those kicks. Goes for a... go about saying just went for a quick, unexpected cover there. But the VG dad kicking out on a one. Now VG dad hired Irish whip to the corner and catches them with that sitting clothesline. The dad really needs to find a way to start dishing out. Oh, nice diving headbutt to the back. Needs to find a way to start dishing out a little more pain, a little more punishment. He's been delivering a lot of these light moves. Needs to find a way to really start hitting some of those big maneuvers he has. And releases Thomas. Thomas not quite ready to go down yet. Two men colliding there, it looks like. Again, locking up in the center of the ring. And another rake to the eyes. Again, this is what I was talking about. He's been going for all these small maneuvers. He needs to be looking to see if he can get in like the dad slam or the dad drop. Something just to get him back into this match. PTM again with the cover. One. And the dad kicking out on the one. Hard toss into the corner there from Thomas. And a nice German suplex there. Again, working on that back. And a knee to the side of the head. And then a stomp to the arm. Thomas now looking like he's just taking him apart. One, just working bit by bit on each section of the dad. Again, the rear waist hold. Turning back body suplex. Again, working on that back and neck area. And a huge springboard flying splash. Looking to pull him away from the ropes one more time. Gonna look for the cover, I imagine. No. Again, Thomas wasting some time. Not sure what he's thinking about doing there when he gets him down on the ground. The dad again gets into that camel clutch like maneuver there. Kicks him down to the mat. Now getting him up again. Quick snapmare takedown and another big boot to the head. And now mounting and punching in the head. Really working on PTM's head right now. Now he has Thomas up, again with that quick snapmare takedown, and another boot to the face. Oh, Thomas though, reversing it. Oh, both men just colliding, and again catches him with that forearm smash in the corner. And another big forearm to the side of the face, and then a running bulldog. Goes for the cover, one, two, and the VG dad kicks out again. Oh, the reverse Yoshi ride! Catches him off guard with a reverse Yoshi ride. One, two, three. Ladies and gentlemen, PTM retains his championship one more time. Congratulations to you, Thomas. And there you see the champ with his belt after a very hard-fought match with the VG Dad. The VG Dad put on a very, very good fight, really stayed with it to the end, but unfortunately was caught off guard by the reverse Yoshi ride. Usually we see him win with that Walls of Mario, but tonight, catching his opponent off guard and finding a way to retain his championship. And as always, thank you for watching YouTube Championship Wrestling. If you liked all the YTCW action, make sure you give us a like down there. If you really liked it, make sure you subscribe so you don't miss any future YTCW wrestling action. So, until next video, this is Adam, signing off.